Not going to modernize. Not going to sugarcoat. Not going to compromise just to get a few likes, just to hit people, hit the like button. Brother, I want God to like what I'm doing. I want Jesus to like what I'm doing and what I'm saying. Hey, man, a lot of preachers today, can I just preach what God's given me to preach? I'm talking about God being pleased with us. A lot of preachers have changed their message. They've got away from thus saith the word of God, and they got into fables and fairy tales and stories and Jack and the Beanstalk. And things that make entertain people, make them feel good. Shame on you. I don't believe God's pleased with that. I don't believe he'll pat you on the back and say, there to go, boy. Way to go, boy. I don't believe he'll do it. Amen. You better get back to the real thing. You better get back to God's word and leave the rest of this stuff alone. Amen. People don't want to hear that. They want to hear, give me the next big thing. I've seen it. It's like an epidemic going into churches. It takes two or three people to start up something. And then all of a sudden, all the churches seem to be doing it and going after it. Brother, if it don't line up precept upon precept with God's word, it's a heresy, brother. It ain't no good for nothing. It's to be cast out. The salt has lost their savor. And thank God, under the feet of men to be trampled upon. Brother, amen. The Bible said, Jesus said, repent. Quickly, or I'll remove the candlestick out of its place. Brother, you'll walk into some of these churches where they used to have the Spirit of God in them. They used to have the power, the anointing, the ability, and then all of a sudden it's a cold place. It's dry. It's dead. Nobody's getting delivered. Nobody's getting free. No, but nothing's happening. Nobody's getting saved. Why? Because you got into something else. Is God pleased with you? I'm talking about doing God's will. People say, well, you never know what God's will is. Read his book. You'll find out what his will is. His will is his word, and his word is his will. Thank God. There's nothing new to this, brother. Nobody can tell what God wants me to do. He told me what to do. He told you what to do. Right here, word upon word, chapter upon chapter, verse upon verse. When you get away from the word of God, you're getting into something else. And brother, you need to come back and repent and get your first love back. Oh, this might be too strong for some people. Oh, we want our crowds to be big. We want our Sunday school attendance to go up. That's why we've getting ever into fun and entertainment and Ferris wheels and games and plays and modernized and letting sin come in and all this good stuff. We want our Sunday school number to go up. Brother, I'm here to tell you, you can have everybody come from Corbin and you can have them come from London. You can have hundreds and thousands, but if they ain't hearing the word of God, they're leaving out lost. Thank God it still takes God's word to change somebody's life. That's what it takes. Praise God. Don't take no raffle. Don't take no Ferris wheel outside in the parking lot. I'm talking about the Spirit of God is able to quicken and to prick your heart and get a hold of you and lead you to Jesus. Brother, his power's real. Is God pleased with you? Is God pleased the shape that the world and our country's got in? I don't believe God's pleased with it. We're living in a time and a state. I'm going to slow down. We're living in a time, in a state where people have absolutely, positively, no doubt about it, turned their back against God. I don't need God. It's what a lot of people are saying. I don't want God. I don't want your church. I don't want your gospel. Give me something else. The Bible said back when they had Jesus and Barabbas there, Barabbas represented the world. He was a murderer. He was ready to die, but Jesus was over on the other side. And old Pilate said, which one would you rather have? And the crowd called, give us Barabbas, give us the murderer, give us the man of the world. What to do with Jesus? They cried, crucify him, get him out of here. We don't want him, but praise God, I still want him tonight. I still need him. You can have Barabbas, give me Jesus. That's what the world's saying tonight. Give me something fun. Give me something entertaining. Even in the church, you come in, the man of God's behind the pulpit. He's got his Bible open, and he's teaching, thus saith the word of God. Oh, that's not entertaining enough for me. Give me somebody that's going to get some jump rope and do something. Swing from the chandeliers. Amen. Well, if God's in it, that's all right. But if you don't know the word of God, you're leaving out empty. You can shout. You can flip-flop. You can do cartwheels, whatever you want to. Do you know the word of God? And are you pleasing to the Lord? That's what I want to know. Hey, brother, I've shouted with the best of them. I've run the aisles with the rest of them. But if you don't know the word of God, you're getting into something else. It's all about the music. It's all about the entertainment. It's all about the feel good. What about God's word? It's supposed to be all about God.